Previously,
nominated for eviction this week are Anton and Jay.
Anton and Jay were up, then out.
In a few minutes, you will leave the Big Brother house and enter a secret room.
What?
Oh my God.
It's a joke.
You become legends.
This is what Big Brothers are about.
Tonight,
la, 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 la.
The housemates get scared.
No, because they're going to lose their lights out.
Jem gets suspicious.
I think it is like he goes away sometimes to calculate what's going to happen next. That just concerns me a bit sometimes.
And the plotting continues.
They underestimated the villain. They really did.
I'm gonna terrorize the place.
Day 40, 8:54 a.m. The house is waking up to the after effects of some supernatural activity. Yesterday, Big Brother surprised Jay and Anton with a twist.
You will leave the Big Brother house through the door to your left.
All right.
But you haven't been evicted. Yet.
Oh, yet.
Oh, yet.
Today, your housemates nominated you for the public vote, but Big Brother is giving you the chance to change that. Anton and Jay, you will now leave the Big Brother house and enter a secret room. You will have the power to change this week's nominations.
Holy shit.
Yes! Smart villains back!
That off!
You'll all get a big shock if it's true, though.
It's not true.
It's not true at all.
Have they gone? No.
I'll give you everything you'll ever need, and I'll find a way to turn you into.
Now dead to their living and breathing housemates, they must silently haunt the house and watch their every move from a crypt in the garden. Big Brother has delivered instructions for this week's shopping task.
For this week's shopping task, housemates will be entering the spine-tingling world of the supernatural. For today's task, very simply, housemates must not scream. Big Brother will only allow housemates 3 screams all day. Any more than 3 screams and you will fail the shopping task. Oh God. Housemates, keep calm and carry on. Whatever you do, just don't scream, Big Brother.
They're going to do stuff to try and make us scream.
Housemates might think they know what they have to do, but success in this week's shopping task actually rests in the hands of their 2 undead housemates. And Big Brother is about to put a direct call into the afterlife.
Jay, the housemates have just been set their task not to scream for the next 24 hours.
Right.
They think that they will fail the task if they scream more than 3 times. However, what they don't know is that they'll actually fail the task unless they scream more than 3 times. And it'll be down to you to choose the biggest squealers to ensure that Big Brother really hears some screams. Big Brother will get back to you when he's ready to drop some scream bombs.
She has Big Brother.
What is it?
Right, basically, I've got to watch the screen. But if they don't scream three times, they fail the shopping task. Do you think if they do scream three times, they pass the shopping task?
Okay. All we can do is sit here and watch for now.
(clears throat) 10:06 a.m. Louise has come to the diary room.
It's strange, actually. I woke up this morning and just thought, God, where are they? Like, where is they? I think, because he's left, I know he'll be enjoying himself and eating nice food, seeing his friends and family, so I'm thinking positive, really. But everyone's told me it's not true, so I'm thinking that as well. I'll be fine. I'm a strong woman.
How much are you missing him, Louise?
This much.
With a day of scares ahead, Louise is first on the ghouls' hit list.
Get yourself back over to that monitor, Anton.
OK.
Thanks, Anton.
Cheers, bye.
Harry?
Yeah?
If we get three screams, does that mean we don't get a luxury?
Yeah.
We just get a basic?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I didn't appreciate how good looking she was, and I seen her tell you that. Looks well, tell you. My mates will be like, she's fit.
Blood coming out of the shower.
Is it cold?
Boiling.
That is hilarious. Actually.
I didn't see.
Uh-oh.
So we've only got two left.
And they've already eyed up their second target, Tom.
Yes.
Big Brother will do that for you.
Cheers, mate. Ta.
Oh, my God, we're so gonna fail. The mirror went dark and a skeleton appeared in front of us.
Oh, my God. Well, we failed the task and it's another week of basic food again because everyone is, like, pathetic.
Coming up, Anton gets evil.
They didn't take the villain seriously. They will this time.
And Jem gets suspicious.
I think it is like he goes away sometimes to calculate what's going to happen next.
(clears throat) 11:01 a.m. As part of this week's supernatural shopping task, undead housemates Anton and Gia were told they were both evicted last night. However, Big Brother has confined them to a crypt in the garden. They have been haunting their fellow housemates for 55 minutes. The rest of the housemates believe they're only allowed to scream three times to pass this week's shopping task.
Hello, Anton.
Anton is on the crypt phone to Big Brother.
Big Brother would like you to call one housemate to the diary room and plunge them into darkness. When the lights come back on, they won't be alone.
Yeah.
Who do you want to hit right now?
Louise.
How ghoulish of you. Get yourself back over to the monitor and make sure Jay joins you.
Jay, get up. They're calling Louise to the diary room now.
Having clocked up two screams, housemates believe they're only allowed to scream one more time.
Hello, Louise.
Hiya.
How are you?
Starving.
How do you think everyone in the house is handling today's task?
I think, like, you could have done it a bit better, to be honest, Big Brother.
And do you think there will be any more screams today?
No.
Alex is doing her hair.
Oh, don't your arms ache when you're putting your hair up?
Fuck!
Oh, no, what?
Housemates believe that in order to pass the task, they're not permitted any more screams.
Have you got another file?
<coughs> 12:47 p.m. Harry and Aaron are in the sauna having a private chat about Anton, who's listening in.
Regardless of whether he's always been a good mate of hers, you know, he's always been a good mate of mine, but I find it hard to live with him sometimes.
Do you feel like he's improved the last couple of days?
After Friday, he seemed much more mellow.
It was bizarre seeing him cry.
Anton.
What's wrong? I think he's upset. I think he'd completely convinced himself he's gone.
I didn't speak to him about it at all. I'd be interested to know what it was that was making him cry, whether it was just the shock of staying. Because I imagine, I mean, as much as you put on the front, no one wants to go out to booze.
In the bedroom, the girls are getting morbid.
You know, when I die, I need a makeup artist.
You get a makeup artist when you die anyway?
Yeah, they do like a clown.
Do they?
Like rouge cheeks and red lips, you know. I wanna be put in like position of that when I die.
I wanna be put in a position like this when I die.
I want this one.
I want that. I want that one. I say I want a mobile phone put in me.
In case you're buried alive.
But I want to be cremated because I don't want to wake up in my coffin.
Oh, yeah, but what if you wake up in your coffin while you're being cremated?
Back to the flames? I know.
This is like watching fucking paint dry. Yeah. To me and you, you get back in that house, mate. You know what now what it looks like. I'm going all out. I'm spacing that fucker up.
Aaron and Fear are defining their online status.
Okay, what would our status be? Friends, it's complicated, or we are in a relationship.
Option C.
Or seeing each other.
I reckon that the third one.
It's complicated.
No.
Seeing?
No.
Single?
No.
So which one does that leave?
Well, what do you think?
I want you to say it.
We're having relations.
Oh my God. Embarrassing.
Jem is talking to Big Brother.
I think maybe someone here is not concentrating on wanting to win the prize money, but they get their kicks from setting little games off around the house and sometimes watching them. And then if they come to fruition, they get like a little sense of achievement out of that. The only problem occurs when I'm worried that it involves my sister and her emotions. She's kind of sucked into falling in love with guys very easily, and very often it's the wrong guy.
Jem, can you clarify for Big Brother which housemate you were talking about?
Aaron. If he was the right guy, he'd be really good for her because she looks up to him and respects him. So anything that he tells her, she will believe and do and take on board, which is a really good thing. If he's true, I've given her advice before when they've fallen out, saying, you know, no, it's fine. Maybe he's just a bit sensitive or stressed and kind of made excuses for if he's gone off in a mardy and stuff, because I want her to get on with him because she enjoys being with him. But if it does all go pear-shaped, then I don't want her to be left there having bad memories of this experience. And should the need be, if I think she's in danger of getting hurt, I will get involved if I need to.
...3:19 PM. Anton's plans are back on track.
If Aaron went home, if we think that, I would love some. Although, maybe it should just be Harry.
They underestimated the villain. They really did. They didn't take the villain seriously. They will this time.
Aaron and Fear are under the covers.
I wonder what my mum will think of you.
I think she might, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. And it's only because you lick everyone's arse, Aaron.
I don't.
Yeah, you do. I can imagine you being like, oh, you're a really nice woman. Do you want me to, pour the tea? I'll help you with that.
Just because I'm nice and polite, it doesn't mean when we're out, I'm going to rip your clothes off.
What?
What?
What are you going on about?
What?
What are you going to about ripping my clothes off for? What's that got to do with anything?
Just saying, that's not just entirely me. I'm not just all...
You've never ripped my clothes off.
No, I haven't yet.
What do you mean, yet?
Well, I plan to at some stage.
What?
What do you mean, what?
You plan to at some stage?
What, on the outside?
What, so you've already thought about that in your head?
Mm.
Yes? Mm. Aaron!
What? God, I'm phoning. I need to get in bed.
Why?
Why? Because I can't stop kissing you.
Is that bad?
No. I don't like to feel like I'm bothering you. No, it's no good. I've got to get up.
What?
I've got to get up.
Why?
Because I'm going to pounce on you in a minute.
You're not.
I am.
You're not. That's happened. Aaron, what's wrong with you?
I don't know. There's someone in the water today.
You're scaring me.
Why?
Because you're never like this.
What, a bit racy?
A bit saucy.
A bit saucy.
4:09 p.m. Alex and Tom are fighting over sofa space.
Tom, you're going to have to move.
Are you fucking serious, Roy? I've been sat here for, like, half an hour.
No, you haven't. Yeah, but my legs were up here and then you just came up and moved your
There's
legs.
There's no way I'm moving my legs.
There's no way I'm
There's
moving
no
mine.
There's no fucking way.
Kids.
Wow.
Jem has grabbed Sister Fear for a private word about Aaron.
He's very intelligent,
yeah.
And I know that he's playing a game in the house because that's his fun of being here.
Yeah.
From watching history, he wants to see if he can crack the code, so to speak.
Yeah.
I came in being wary of him because of things that I've seen that other people haven't. And some things kind of make me think what I have seen is the true him. And some things make me think that I'm just being paranoid.
What, did you think he doesn't like me then?
No, I'm not saying that at all. I wonder if sometimes he creates dramas just to make entertaining television for the both of you. Do you know what I mean? Which would benefit both of you, because you get airtime, but then again, it hurts your heart if he's doing that, and I don't think it's fair if he does.
This is a myth. I knew it. So, I told you, Sam.
Now I'm worried that he doesn't genuinely like you.
No, he genuinely likes you. But he's making television with you too, you know what I mean? That's what I want to find out. Because even if he genuinely likes you and he's fallen in love with you, and he's thinking, oh, if I just piss away off a little bit, you'll have a margin, then we'll be on TV more, which will raise that profile. Well, someone could still be in love with you and do that.
Not in love with me.
Yeah, but that's the gradual process that occurs. So I'm just trying to figure out what it is at the moment.
This is...
I think it is like he goes away sometimes to get his guard back up and process all the goings on in the house so that then he can calculate what's going to happen next. And that just concerns me a bit sometimes.
He does know everything. I think it is a fucking big game to stay on the telly.
Of course it is, mate.
But he's never going to admit that to Jem.
But I'll tell you what, mate. We've heard Jem say she was wary of him before she came. If we go out there to the house and say, Jem, Aaron's been talking behind your back. Then we also tell the house that Aaron is playing a game. It'll confirm that conversation. Fate will then believe us. What if I go in the house and I go, like, what if I go in the house with you and I go, in front of everyone, Aaron's playing a game?
I don't mind doing that.
I just believe that
Aaron's playing a game.
Before we fucking dig anything, we'll sit down, we'll talk, we'll put it out, we can't kill the lot. And then we've got to make sure we don't exaggerate what's being said, and we need to keep it as real as possible so then the public didn't hate us for doing this. Do you know what I mean?
Coming up, Aaron's scared.
That scared the life out of me.
No.
And Alex has had enough.
And I'm afraid to go back out there because you're gonna have some stupid little shit running about outside.
Five or four p.m.
You've been shocked yet?
No.
Supernatural forces have taken over the house for this week's shopping task. To pass, housemates think they must not scream more than three times in 24 hours. What they don't know is that Big Brother has challenged undead housemates, Jay and Anton, to make them all scream more than three times by picking which housemate should face each supernatural challenge.
Yeah, Aaron, please. Cheers, baby, bye-bye.
This is Big Brother with Aaron come to the diary room.
Oh, mate. Oh, dear. Beware.
in your bed. Boom.
Hello, Aaron.
Hello.
What's it like with only seven housemates in the house now?
It's very quiet, actually. It's very kind of... because it suddenly feels like a very expansive place. So there's lots of room, so you can just, you know, mill around and you don't really interfere with people. But I actually miss Jay and Anton. I had lots of reasons to dislike them, but I do miss their presence in the house, I think, because like Jay kept Lou happy, Anton kept everybody unhappy, so it's just, you know, a happy medium.
And what do you miss about them?
I think I just, because of the fact that for my whole duration of being here, they've been a constant, and like, I don't miss Jay's windbreaking when Anton and I'd start getting on a little bit recently, so, you know, didn't detract from my reasons for nominating them and stuff, and wanting them to be out before others. But, you know, you balance out, I guess.
Thank you, Aaron. And remember not to scream at anything today, if you can help it.
OK.
You can leave the diary room now.
I don't want to leave at the moment. Oh, no, there's going to be something out there, isn't there? Oh, for crying out loud. Are they real? Oh, my God.
How are you, man? How are you? Girl, get out there, man.
There seems to have been an incident in the hallway there. Someone looks like they've been a bit slippy with a knife. There seems to be a few dead bodies out there. Not really sure I want to go out there. They look pretty real. What's happening?
He's screaming.
Oh, I'm shaking.
Is there a problem?
No, apparently not. That scared the life out of me. Oh, he's trying so hard as well. I thought I was being really butch by giving it a prod. Oh, I'm all sweaty. Oh, dear.
Is that right, girl?
Huh? 9:09 p.m. Anton and Jay still have Aaron on their minds.
So you think there's no one who can beat Aaron?
I think there is.
Who?
I mean, I think I could probably maybe...
No, I mean out of...
Oh, them?
Because the only reason why I think Alex still might win it is because the other day the crowd were going, "We love Alex," before the show. "We love Alex."
Were they?
Yeah. Alex, Alex.
Alex is a lot more innocent than Aaron is, like.
Yeah. I still think... Alex might be Aaron, though. She might be him, because she's not got a bad bone in her body.
It's time for Alex to come face to face with an old friend.
This is Big Brother. Would Alex come to the diary room?
No, I'm not.
Oh, Alex,
just be prepared, Alex.
He's a guy, just a time.
It's fine.
No, I can't go in, I don't want to do it.
Look at me.
Nothing will hurt you. Okay? It's just someone dressed up like we're doing a dress for Halloween.
It's basically someone like Tom dressed up.
Alex, just think about how many bars of chocolate you can get if you don't scream.
I don't want the chocolates.
Well, anything.
Think how many I can get if you don't scream.
No, I don't think I can do it.
You'll be fine. Just in you go.
Fuck's sake. Walk up to
the fucker. Walk up with him.
Yeah, I'll leave you when you get to the door, though. Right, open the door.
Have a little
peep.
You
open it. No, you've got to open it. I'll hold your hand.
Alex, have a peep in there.
It'll be fine, seriously. Look, nothing in there.
Wait.
It's a diary room chair.
No, because they're going to switch the lights out.
No, no, no.
Alex, honestly, you'll be fine. I promise you, you'll be fine.
Alex, you'll be fine. You'll be fine, OK? Nothing in there.
Yeah, come in.
You're gonna be okay. See, there's nothing in there. There's nothing in there.
Are you alright?
No, I don't
want to
be in
here! You'll be fine.
Louise, please close the diary room door now. Alex, hello, what? How are you?
I'm sick, your arseholes! I don't want to be in here!
Alex, you don't even know what Big Brother's asked you there for. Alex, are you missing your pet chihuahua?
Yeah.
What's she called?
Tinkerbell.
Well, Big Brother thought you might be missing her. And as we are past the halfway stage of the series, thought you might like to see her for 10 minutes next door in the small task room. Big Brother transported her down from Newcastle and can tell you that she was rather nervous during transportation. She's left a blanket over the cage to keep her calm.
No, you haven't. No, you haven't. Oh, no! Let us out! Let us out!
Alex?
No, I don't want to go in there! I know what it is! It's going to be some little monster shit in a cage or something!
She's a fucking idiot. A fucking idiot. It's embarrassing.
Oh, God.
Alex?
What?
What if Big Brother let Tom come in the room with you?
Yes. Yes, get Tom, please.
Really, this is Big Brother. Can Tom come to the diary room?
Oh my God.
Come in.
Is this my task?
No, it's
not. So I just get reeled in for both.
Let's just quick.
Ting. Do you really not want to go in
there? I'm really fucking scared, man. I don't like shit like this.
Will Tom and Alex return to the diary room?
How do you feel, Alex? How do you feel screaming at the sight of Tashi with her dog's body?
Oh, I feel so stupid. Oh, how embarrassing.
10:17 p.m. Jay and Anton are asleep in the crypt. The girls are talking about boys.
I knew the fire'd go off with Aaron, though. I knew it.
Did you? Mm. Straight away? How?
Because she looks like his ex, her ex.
Really?
He looks like her ex, yeah.
Did you protect anyone else or not?
I said, no, I just said him, basically, because his mannerisms were like her ex as well.
Did you think I would get with that again or not?
Nah.
Did you think I'd get with anyone?
Nah.
Really?
Do you think I would get with anyone?
Why did you think I wouldn't?
Because you're too classy.
Oh, God.
Like, Mrs. Sophisticated. Mm-hmm. I imagine that you'd go out with someone that's kind of like Harry person, but more handsome.
Not Jay.
No.
Jay's... I go for people more like Jay, though. Mm. Like, my ex is a bit like Jack the Lad type of thing.
Yeah, but to look at, you'd think that you're, like, a proper lady, do you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. Wouldn't think you'd ever burp or fart looking at you.
But I do.
Yeah.
It's the romance what's done it for me.
Yeah.
Aaron has come to the diary room.
Do you think Jem approves of your relationship with Faye?
Kind of. She has said to me a couple of things that's made me think, yeah, she, you know, she's okay with us. And I do feel like she's only been here 5 minutes.
Are you happy for Faye that she's met Aaron?
I don't know Aaron yet, do I?
Yeah, he hasn't really.
I don't talk to him that much, so I don't know him yet. I don't think you can really get to know someone until you're not in the house.
I'll be honest, we don't really talk that much. She does like to belch quite frequently, and that kind of scares me. I just kind of think I don't need to panic about getting to know her. If Faye and I are going to have this lasting relationship, we're going to have plenty of time to get to know her, and I'm slowly getting to know her. But I think I see new people as a daddy long legs would with a light bulb, because when they land on them, they're all like, ooh, 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 ooh. And I'm just like that. I don't know what to do. I don't know where to put myself. So it's awkward. Or I'm awkward, I should say.
I just don't want to get hurt again,
Jem,
because people...
Stop it, because you couldn't let it hurt.
I don't want to get hurt because she falls in love really easily.
Does she? I like Faye. I think she's a nice girl.
I think she needs to be loved by a man.
Yeah, I think so. I get that a little bit with her.
Like she's insecure without it kind of thing. That might change one day, but that's how she is at the moment. She likes to have her...
She's only young still, though, isn't she?
Yeah.
Coming up, Harry gets scared.
So spiders. I don't know spiders. I'm not sure why I've just told you that.
And Anton declares war.
I'm gonna terrorise the place.
...11:20 PM. Big Brother is on the crypt phone to Anton.
Hello, hello, hello.
They have a shock in store for one more housemate.
Let's knock him down. Let's knock him down a peg or two.
It's guaranteed to be flesh crawling.
Brilliant. Thanks a lot, Big Bro.
Bye.
Get changed. Sit down.
This is Big Brother. Will Harry come to the diary room?
Oh, no. Harry.
Faye.
That won't count as one.
That will count as one.
Don't
God.
Go on, then, Harry.
Go on, Harry.
Oh, God.
Do you want to say? Good luck, hon.
Cheers. See you in a bit.
OK.
Da-da-da-da. All right, my brother.
Hello, Harry.
Hello.
How are you?
apprehensive, is one word I'd say, on an evening like tonight. Yeah, slightly nervous, but good otherwise, yeah.
What's the worst thing you could face?
Spiders. I don't know, spiders. I'm not sure why I've just told you that. What I'm actually even more terrified of is naked girls. Oh God, that would really scare me. Bunny rabbits. They are get me spine tingling. So if you've got any of those back there, food as well. That's scary.
Thank you, Harry. You can now return to the house.
Good one. Good one. Shall I go now? Big brother.
What is it? What happened?
Spiders.
Real?
Real ones?
Nah.
No. What did you do? What did you do?
Spiders.
What did I do?
Yeah.
Scream.
Spiders.
That was it. That was the thing.
Were they like...
And then I just went, wee.
What, were they fake ones?
That was it.
Ridiculous. Harry's just been in the day room, giving it the big and that. Totally different person, I'd say. Fee, you didn't say shut the fuck up, won't you? He's one of the most annoying people I've ever seen. Ring, ding, 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 ding. What a bunch of clowns.
AM. Most of the housemates are in bed.
Aaron and Harry, I hope you know if anything does happen, your beds are the first two I'm going
to. Yeah, I'm not sorry, like, but Harry, Aaron...
I'd go for Harry.
You're getting fearful.
Either or.
I'd go for Aaron, he's stronger.
You're taller. I think you're stronger than Aaron.
No.
You big man mountain.
I've got nothing to lose. So when I go out in there, I'm gonna terrorise the place. I'm gonna be a maniac. I'm going all guns blazing, suicide mission. I can't wait to get back in. I'm gonna create a war zone. And when the dust settles, I want you in the final, mate. Do it. Do it for the real people.
Turn over to 5-star now for Big Brother's Bit on the Side for the shocking conclusion to Jay and Anton's challenge. Plus, Emma Willis will be joined by former housemates Dean Bowers, Corinne Forshaw and Nikki Graham.